The artist, formerly known as Prince, is also known for his way with the ladies, launching the careers of Wendy and Lisa, Vanity, and Apollonia. Perhaps his most talented protege is the artist currently known as Sheila E. In 1984, Prince convinced a percussionist named Sheila Escovedo to simply call herself Sheila E. He also beckoned Sheila out from behind her timbales, suggesting she sing instead. Prince produced Sheila's debut solo LP, The Glamorous Life. She struck an instant hit with its title song. Prince also turned up on Sheila's second album. The two sang duet on its single, Love Bizarre. After her third LP, Sheila gave up her solo act and joined the Revolution, reigning over the drum kit in Prince's backup band. Sheila never wanted the Revolution to end.
This is an ideal band, and none of us want to leave, not unless he fires me, but I doubt that.
In fact, Prince fired everyone but Sheila. A few months later, the Revolution was history. On her own, Sheila kept pounding the skins and the guys who wore them, hoping to resume her solo career with a funky new record called Sex Symbol. The day she finished recording, life harshly interrupted.
I was driving in the car, leaving the studio, and all of a sudden I had a tingling in my left arm, and it felt like I was having a heart attack. When I finally got to the hospital and they took x-rays, they told me that my lung had collapsed 80%.
Her recovery would take 6 months. Unable to support her new album, Sheila watched helplessly as sales plummeted. So where is Sheila now?
I just had to start all over again. You know, I had to take one day at a time and take even walking one block took a lot of effort.
The effort paid off in 1998 when Sheila made TV history by becoming the first female musical director for late night television.
It's the magic hour.
Sheila credits more than herself for success.
The only thing that keeps me going is God. If I didn't have Jesus in my life, I wouldn't be here, I think. And I can't do anything without him.
But not even a higher power could save the magic hour. The show was canceled. Sheila, however, is still on track with her brother Peter Michael and their band, The E-Train. And she's not looking back.
I wouldn't change anything that I had done in the past up to now, because that led me to the person that I am now. And I like who I am now.
In 1980, Prince met a former toothpaste model named Denise Matthews and turned her into one nasty girl. He tried to convince her to change her name to get attention. Prince suggested Vagina. She chose Vanity. She became leader of a camisole-wearing girl group called Vanity Six, even though there were only three of them. In 1984, though, Prince and Vanity broke up. He went on to create Apollonia Six, and she got engaged to Motley Crue's Nikki Six. Both relationships were soon 86'd. Then Vanity searched for answers in the form of past life regression.
My last life, I was a ballerina. I just found that out this year.
So where are they, she, now?
Hallelujah!
Today, Vanity is back to Denise.
Vanity was this person that was supposed to be glamorous. And when you looked at her, you saw glamour. And you saw everything that you possibly wanted to be. When I looked at her, I hated her. It was nothing that I wanted to be.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord.
I was so messed up on drugs, and I never believed that I could actually be delivered from cocaine.
Save us, Father.
Just when she changed her life by becoming born again, Denise learned her time was about to run out.
First they told me I was going to die. Then they ripped out my kidney. Oh, man, I felt like I had been tortured.
Denise spent months in intensive care for kidney failure. During that time, Prince called to wish her well. They reportedly haven't talked since. These days, Denise has found herself a new prince. Defensive end for the Oakland Raiders, Anthony Smith. Vanity may be damned, but Denise is the happiest she's ever been.
Even when I'm upset, it's better than what it used to be.
Does that make any sense?
And boy, I can talk like the Dickens when it comes to Jesus Christ. Somebody stop me.